Now we will study about the who is more powerful, the legislature or the executive, okay, with a case study which is given in the page number 282 of your book. There was a clash between President Rajendra Prasad and Prime Minister Jawaharlal Nehru over the issue of the powers of the president soon after the India was proclaimed as republic. So there was a clash, that means there was a views, that means the opinion different between the President of India Rajendra Prasad and the Prime Minister of India Jawaharlal Nehru over the issue that what are the powers of the president. Okay, and when this clash started, soon after India became republic. In March 1950, President Rajendra Prasad wrote to Prime Minister Nehru and stated that as the president, he had the right to act independently of the advice of the Council of Ministers, and he had the right to act in consultation with secretaries to Government of India. So in the year 1950, in the month of March, President, that is the Rajendra Prasad, he had wrote a letter to the Prime Minister of India, that is Jawaharlal Nehru, and in that letter he said that the President of India has the right to act independently, that means he can decide anything independently, no other person can influence his decision, okay, and he can act independently on the advice of the Council of Ministers, okay, and he had the right to act, that means he can act independently with the consultation with the secretaries who are appointed to the Government of India. Dr. Prasad even sought the opinion of Attorney General M.C. Sittalworth on the constitutional position of the president. So even Rajendra Prasad, he said that the Attorney General of India, that is M.C. Sittalworth, his position is a constitutional position, okay, and it is come under the president, that means president will decide the Attorney General of India. Stawell replied that the president had the right to dismiss the ministry and dissolve parliament. So the Attorney General of India, he replied to president, that is Rajendra Prasad, that the president had the right to dismiss any ministers and dissolve the parliament. So Dr. Prasad asserted that he had the power to withhold assent to the bill, that he could dismiss a minister or the ministry, dissolve parliament and order fresh general election. So now the Dr. Prasad, he got the power, that he had the main power to assent to the bill, that means with his permission or with his signature a bill will be implemented into a law. If he will not give his assent or if he will not sign the bill, that bill will not be implemented in our country. He also said that he had a power to dismiss a minister or a whole ministry, that means the whole department. Even the president have the power to dissolve the parliament, that means to dissolve the Lok Sabha, if he think that the prime minister is not qualified for the position. And the president have the power to order for fresh general election when the parliament or the Lok Sabha is dissolved. Prasad added that he was not bound to act on the advice of the Council of Ministers against the decision of the state authority, even in matters falling exclusively within the latter's jurisdiction. Even Rajendra Prasad, he said that he is not bound, that means he does not have to act or make laws according to the advice of the Council of Ministers. Okay, and he cannot make laws against the Council of Ministers if that decision is against the state authority, that means whatever is mentioned in our Indian Constitution, if it violates our Indian Constitution, then that law cannot be implemented in our country, and it is totally dependent upon the president whether this law will be implemented or not. And he should always keep in mind that whatever laws are implemented in our country or whatever decision he is taking in the parliament, that should be according to the Indian Constitution. It does not violate our jurisdiction, that means the rights which are given in our Indian Constitution. Nehru, that is the Prime Minister of India, too short the advice of the Attorney General. Shuttleworth said that the President should act according to the advice of the Council Ministers, and also added that the President could not dismiss a Council of Ministers enjoying the confidence of the House and order general election. So Nehru supported the advice of the Attorney General. He said that the President, that is the Rajendra Prasad, cannot act according cannot act independently. He or she have to take advice of the Council of Ministers if he or she is taking a decision for the our country. Even the President cannot dismiss a Council of Ministers who is enjoying the confidence of the House. That means a President cannot dismiss the Council of Ministers if the Prime Minister the Prime Minister have the majority section in the Lok Sabha. That means how our Prime Minister is elected, if any political party get maximum number of votes, that party form the government. Okay, at present is the BJP government. So the BJP government had got lots of, or you can say maximum number of seats in the Lok Sabha election. That's why it formed the government. Okay, so once the Prime Minister is decided, Prime Minister will make list of Council of Ministers who belongs to his or her party. That means at present is BJP government. So who all are the members of the Council of Ministers? It is the BJP government. So according to Attorney General Shuttleworth, he said that the President cannot dismiss, that means cannot force to any Council of Ministers to resign from their position if they are enjoying the majority of the support from the Lok Sabha. Okay, I hope you have got this idea. I hope this concept is clear. And the other is the President cannot order general election, because every powers, whether it is given to Prime Minister, President or any other ministers, the powers are limited. Okay, so similarly, if the President want to order a fresh election, first of all he have to prove that the Prime Minister is not incapable or he had done some illegal activities which is against our constitution. Once he prove, the Lok Sabha will be dissolved, then he can order for general election. Before that he cannot. He however added that the President could exercise the reserve power for ordering fresh election if he strongly felt the parliament did not reflect the political balance in the country. Just now I have explained you the same thing. However, Shuttleworth, he said that the President can use the reserve power to do a fresh election if he strongly felt or he have proved that the Prime Minister or the Lok's the Prime Minister or the members of the Lok Sabha who are from the Prime Minister's party, if they don't have a proper political balance or if they are doing something illegal against our Indian constitution, then he can order for fresh election. Before that he cannot. In June 1975, the language of Article 74(1) was altered. So in the June 1975, the language article, that is this article, was altered, that means amended, that is changed. The 42 Amendment Act provided that there shall be a Council of Ministers with the Prime Minister at the head to aid and advise the President, who shall in the exercise of his function act in accordance with such advice. So now these law was changed. So according to the 42nd Amendment Act, the Council of Ministers, okay, with the help of Prime Minister, the Prime Minister is the head of the aid. That means the Prime Minister will give advice to the President whether the function of the President, okay, that means the Prime Minister will tell the President about the functions of the President, and the President have to act according with such advice. That means the president cannot take any decision independently. He have to take advice from the prime minister, and the prime minister will take advice from the council of ministers. So this is the new change which was done in 1975. In 1978, the parliament inserted a provision to Article 74(1) which read, again this law was modified, provided that the president may require the council of ministers to reconsider such advice either generally or otherwise, and the president shall act in accordance with the advice tender after such reconsideration. That means, according to this article, the president cannot take any decision independently. He first of all have to take advice from the council of ministers and from the prime minister, so that it will be the welfare of our country. He cannot take independently any decision of his or her own. He have to take advice from the council of ministers and from the prime minister. The president is seen as the head of the state. Though the president is the head of the state, but he or she has to act in accordance with the advice given to him by the prime minister, as it is by the council of minister. Though the president of India is the head of the state, but he or she, that means the president, have to act according with the advice which is given by the prime minister and by the council of minister. He cannot take decision independently. He have to take suggestion and advice from the prime minister of our country and the council of ministers. I hope the concept is clear to everybody.